It is absolutely crazy to me how much BS exists when it comes to marketing. There are so many myths, so many misconceptions, so many lies that are swirling around. How can you possibly know what to do? Here are the five common misconceptions that hold people back from growing their business through really effective marketing. I understand why people don't trust marketers. Marketers can be liars. You really don't know what they're doing unless you have a lot of experience. You pay all of this money, what do you get in return? And unless you're really good, most marketing doesn't work. I hate to say it. I'm a marketer. I love marketing, but there are a lot of bad players out there. There's lots of ways to just piss away dollars. And so when I'm sitting down with someone and they say, listen, I don't believe in marketing. I get it. I understand why. But if you've been doing the same thing year after year and getting the same results, if you're not happy with where your business is or the level of growth you're having, then you gotta try new things. And so the answer isn't to throw away marketing. It's about finding people you can trust and work with who know what they're talking about. And I've seen it. Year after year after year, I get the same people giving me the same misconceptions, and frankly, I'm tired of it. So let's clear some stuff up. Number one, saying I have no time and I have no money. I understand if cash flow is tight, if you're in startup or pre-revenue, coming up with funds can be very, very challenging. But here's the thing. If you have plans, if you have growth and you need people to know who you are, or you just want to generate leads, how are you going to do that if you don't invest time or money? It's ridiculous. You have to invest time or you have to invest dollars, but you can't grow your business without putting in the time, the wrench time, making it happen yourself, learning the things you need to learn, or having someone help you out, or the dollars, hiring the agency, hiring the staff member, doing what you need to do to invest to make sure the machine gets built. Sure, lots of businesses grow without advertising campaigns, but businesses do not grow without some form of marketing, without some form of brand. And so you gotta put in the time. You gotta put in the dollars, but literally you do neither and you will fail. Misconception number two, we got this big without marketing, why would we need it now? When you look at certain industries, mostly manufacturing, mostly B2B, maybe smaller companies, there are a lot of people who have grown a business to a certain size and frankly, they haven't done a lot of marketing. If you are a manufacturer and you're selling through retail, maybe you don't need to do a lot of marketing. Maybe they do it for you. Maybe it's more of a sales-driven organization. But here's the thing. If you're happy with your current size, if you're not really interested in doing anything new, then don't do marketing. That's fine. You got to where you were without doing any marketing at all. Keep doing the same thing. But here's what I see. I sit down with people and they go, oh, we're losing market share. We used to be the biggest and now we're not. There's a new competitor who's nipping at our heels because they're building an amazing brand and they're stealing our customers. We need to meet new people. We need to go into new markets. Yeah, okay, go ahead and give me the reason that you've gotten to where you are without marketing. Your lack of marketing will not get you to where you wanna be. You wanna go to a new place? You better start new activities and you better do them really, really well. Old thinking will get you old results. It's now time for a wake-up call. Misconception number three, a great product doesn't need to be marketed. Listen, marketing cannot fix a garbage product, right? You have a terrible garbage product, you go to market with it, you'll get a few sales, but you're not gonna succeed. So what you need is an amazing product, of course. But even with an amazing product, you better start to grow your market share. You better start to have sales channels. You better connect with people and help explain exactly what this does or why they need it or why they should be emotionally invested in it, why this can help you. You have to do something. Unless if you have endless amounts of time, you better start marketing. Because all effective marketing does is shrink the amount of time it takes to go to market. So let's say you have a great product, the most amazing product in the world, and you decide that you don't want to do any marketing for it. It's going to be a lot of work to get the ones and twos, but that's okay, because the ones and twos will turn into threes and fours, turns into tens and twenties, turns into hundreds, turns into thousands and beyond. That will happen. Can you afford 2 or 3 years? Can you afford the organic process of very slow growth before it starts to hockey stick up? Can you afford to be in market and have a competitor or someone in China see exactly what you're doing, take your product and have them start marketing it? And suddenly now you're in second place. But you can't give up the opportunity and waste all the time by just trusting that organic growth will help you take that amazing product to market. Misconception number four, we are doing social media. Maybe you have a huge following. Maybe you completely rock it. But unless if your marketing strategy is to grow through thought leadership and through social alone, it's not gonna replace a marketing campaign. It's not gonna replace a marketing strategy. You're not gonna be able to introduce yourself to all the people that you need to grow. I don't wanna knock social, because social is a really great way to be able to build a following and a tribe and to become an influencer amongst the community that you build. But that is a long-term solution and you have to do it really well. Frankly, most people don't. Most organizations do social so they can say that they're doing it. They're not connecting with anyone, they're not entering into conversations, and they're not engaging. They are literally just pushing out content. And guess what? No one cares about what they have to say. And so it's awesome that you're doing social, but listen, chances are you should be doing it better. You're not very good at it. And unless if that's your number one strategy, it is not gonna replace a proper marketing strategy, brand building, lead generation, sales funnels. It's not gonna replace these things. So the answer isn't only one. The answer is to divide and conquer. Misconception number 5, marketing is about getting new customers. Yes, your number one objective should be to market to gain new customers, to increase your market share, to have more people know who you are, to build out your lists, but that's not it alone. With how tight the current market is, how hard is it for you to recruit and keep great talent? What about your current customers? You spent all of this money and time and effort to bring them in. Are you staying in front of them? Do they know all the areas of the business you can help them? Do they feel good when you reach out to them, if you reach out to them at all? So while advertising is about going out and capturing new customers, marketing is about building a brand and staying in front of people. And that could be for culture, it can be for recruitment, it can be about staying in front of your current customers so they think of you, so you stay top of mind, so you introduce new products, new services. Marketing is about connecting with people and building a tribe. So yes, you certainly wanna bring in new people to the top of that bucket, but you wanna keep the people within your tribe engaged, loving you, and aware of everything that you can do to help them. As I said, there are tons of lies out there. And this type of thinking, these misconceptions, if you work for a company where the people believe this, it's killing you, it's destroying you. The companies that you all look up to, they do not think this way. They do not allow these reasons or, frankly, excuses to slow them down or hold them back. And so you better get your organization on page. Marketing today is a must. But don't waste your dollars. Look for the truth and work with people who actually have your back. Stuff frustrates me so much, man. I hear it every day. If growing and scaling your business is important to you, be sure to check out this video on marketing. I think you'll love it a lot. And I'd appreciate it if you'd subscribe to my channel now.